Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and today I am going to talk about my favorites for May, and I think actually I'm a little bit out of luck with this favorite videos, but in this favorite video I am also going to talk about two things that I am not that fond of, that I am a little bit disappointed in. So I think I will start with this. The two products that I don't like is one skincare and one makeup tool. Okay, so we can start with the skincare product that I am not that fond of. It's the Glossier Milky Jelly Cleanser. And I have heard so much good things about this. And one of my internet friends, she has a blog and she has wrote about this and she really, really likes it. It's nothing wrong with it, but you know, when it's such a hype product and you're like, you can't wait to get your hands on it, and then you have it and you use it and it's just like, it's okay, it's nothing more. So I am not thrilled about this. It makes me happy in one way because it's not a cheap cleanser, but at the same time it's not a cheap cleanser. I think it's okay, I am not going to buy this again. I guess it's nothing for me. I don't think I like it. It's got a gel consistency, of course, because it's a milky jelly cleanser, conditioning face wash. It is not just my thing. I think I like oils or foam. Or just milky, but not like jelly things. So I don't like it that much. I'm going to use it up. I've come a little bit. The way I... Can you see it? It's so freaking like... I am like here, so... I have used it, but... It's not a favorite of mine. Simple as that. And the other thing that it's a makeup tool is this sponge. It's dirty now because I used it when I applied my makeup. This is from the Swedish store Kix. It's their own makeup sponge, and... This is so free. It's like too soft, like hard to put on my makeup because it feels like it's just, I don't like this sponge. It feels like it takes kind of a lot of product and it's just too, like, it is so soft. It's hard to like get the foundation out, and I have heard so many good things about their sponges, but I don't know. And I don't know, because me, Jessica, and Angelica, we talked about this, or I don't know if Angelica tried this, but I know that Jessica had, I think, we talked about makeup sponges. On Kix, they have this light one and a dark pink, and apparently it's no difference on them, but I squeezed them in the store, and this felt softer, and I was like, I don't like hard sponges, so I take the one that feels a little bit softer. But this is too soft. I don't like it at all. Not for concealer, not for my foundation. It's not a good sponge. So I think I'm going to try the dark pink and see if that is better. If you have tried both of them, is it any difference Is it any difference between them? Please let me know. And then I also have two skincare products that I has liked this month. So I think we take them first and then we go into the makeup. So the first skincare product is a product that I have gone back to. I have had this maybe 2 years ago. I liked it then, but then I like forgot about it, and now I bought it again and I love this one. It is from The Body Shop. It's the Vitamin E Overnight Serum in Oil. And I have finally come to my senses that I need oil at night. Because I have dry skin, and the only thing that really helps and makes my skin better for the day after is to use an oil at night. And this oil I really like. It's a really light oil. And I don't like these thicker oils because it feels like they never go down in, like, it feels like they lay on top of your skin. This is a light oil and I just love it, and I think I will keep buying this because it feels really good and I like Body Shop as a skincare brand. Because the other skincare product is also from Body Shop. It's the Carrot Cream. Natural Rich Daily Moisturizer. I got this in the advent calendar that I had last year, and I didn't have any other face cream. The only thing with this is it smells like carrots, of course, because it's carrots in it. But this gives an amazing glow, and it feels really, really nice. I don't know which skin this is for, but it gives a really, really nice glow, and I really like it. So I actually think that I will keep buying this. Didn't know that. Didn't thought that at all. And yeah, now we're going to the makeup, and it feels like I've been talking for so long. So I actually have three things that has been in kind of like my shop, my stash this month that I have really been liking. And it's not the Natasha Bloom palette. There, I said it. So we can start with the two face products, and then it is of course the Clown Blood from Likely Makeup and the Aurora Kit from Anastasia Beverly Hills. And if we will start with the Aurora. I don't know what's up with my language today. My brain. I don't know what's up with me. It looks like this. I have the Moon Child Glow Kit as well. I really like the Moon Child. I have not been liking this at all. But now I have it in my shop, my stash. And I actually really, really like both Eclipse and Luna. Today I actually have Lyra on. I like it as well. I haven't used Orion or Spectra. I've used Helia in at least one look, I think. But they are really like chunky, shimmery highlighters, but I actually like it. I like the Moonchild more though, but this is actually good, and a little bit annoyed with myself that I haven't used this that much, but I'm so happy that I took it in my shop, my stash for April. It's May. Then if we go into the Clown Blush, this is like the most terrifying blush palette ever. I have used these three colors at least once this month, and this one is actually really nice. You need to though be really, really light-handed with them because they are super pigmented. I have used this orange today, and I actually think it looks good, even though I have used an orange blush. And I've used this. This I was a little bit heavy-handed on, or if it was this. I don't know, but I really like these. It feels like if this was the only blushes I had, this would last forever because I dip my brush once, tap it off, and then put it on, and it still is really, really much blush. But I really like this, and if you have this and are a little bit afraid of it, don't be. It's so good. I really, really like it, and it looks like, it doesn't look like I've used it like at all, but I have. And I am so happy that I bought it because it is such a good blush, and it's so fun to have something that is really like this powerful, this pigmented. So of course, the last thing that is kind of in like my shop mustache, I have really been liking the Moondust Palette from Urban Decay. What is it with me? I've done two looks with this, and I don't know why I didn't like it. Maybe because I didn't know how to use it. Because last time I used it, it was quite a long time ago. But now I have used it more, and I am so happy that I have this. The shadows are so, so good. And with a glitter glue, they are amazing. And they are really like, you don't need to have any shadow under them. You can just have a glitter glue, pack them on, and they are opaque. So yeah, I am so happy that I picked this for my palette of the month. I think I actually will keep using this more now after this because I really like it, and I didn't thought I was going to, but I really, really do. And then other eyeshadow palette that I've really been liking this month is the Scarlet Dusk. I did a first impression, and then I've used some of the shades when I have not been filming. It looks like this, not a typical Lisa palette, but it's really good. And like this Pink Moon, it's such a nice pink. And also like these two. I haven't used all the shades, I actually like only use the pink ones. I haven't touched orange yet, but I used at least half of the palette and I really, really like it. And I am a little bit surprised. I didn't know that I was going to like pink that much, but apparently I do now. Where am I? Nobody knows. And then my favorite lipstick for May, this is an old lipstick, but when I was picking out favorites for this month, I was like, has there been any lipstick that I've used like crazy? And yes, it has. And I do not even want to think about how much I've used this lipstick this month. It's Unicorn Blood from Jeffree Star. I know this is going to be the first liquid lipstick ever that I will use up. Because I can't like imagine that it's that much left in this. Because I've used it like crazy. And I love this shade. This is so dark. It's red. It's just amazing. I love it. And I'm going to be sad when this runs out, because I don't know if I want to buy a new one. I think I'm going to check for some dupes in my collection for this. So yeah, really like this one, and this has to be the liquid lipstick that I run out of first. The only thing, I can't like see how much is left. It's not possible. But yeah, I love this color, and I always get like, when I have this on, at least one person comment on my video and is like, you look amazing in that lipstick, and thank you, and I just love it. So yeah, that was all of my favorites for May. It's soon June. What happened? So yeah, I really hoped you liked this. I hope that you liked that I took in two products that I don't like that much. I love to see when people do like my favorites and my fails for a month. I usually don't test that many products that I don't like. Maybe I like the most, or I just am lucky when I buy things. I don't know. But yeah, I really hoped you liked this video. And if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so you don't miss any of my videos. And I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!